Okay, I've had a couple of requests now for a tour of my lot up here up north. And so I'm up here. I have to come up here once a month, whether I want to or not, spring, winter, summer, fall, because I own a pest control company and I have some clients up here that I have to service all year round. Their cabins and stuff for mice and whatnot. So I have to come up no matter what. So anyway, I've had a couple of requests to show the place, so I'll give you a little tour now of the camper and everything, and you can see my little slice of heaven. The first couple hours of every trip up north are spent snow blowing the driveway. I live up in the snow belt region up here and get a lot of snow, so I'll never get in there if I don't. Driveway all snow blowed. You can now pull the truck in. First off, this is the lot with all the snow. It's real pretty this time of year. And of course, there's no bugs. So that's a beautiful thing. So yeah, so let's take a tour. First off, we have the fire pit where I film some of my pipe shows, and this is the wood pile, a wooden lean-to that I built to try to keep some wood dry for campfires. This is the camper, and if you look up there in the tree, you'll see I put a TV antenna up in the tree so I can get some TV reception for weather and stuff. Now the story on this camper is I got it for free, and it was a wreck. It was just destroyed. The roof was all rotted, caved in. This whole front bunk area here, from like this point up, this cab, was all rotted out and sagging. And I took a year and rebuilt the thing. And painted it, of course, and everything, rebuilt it. Then I custom built my own trailer Anyway, my batteries went dead on the camera. So anyway, I built this trailer from scratch. Custom built it. Just to fit this vehicle. And I built a reinforcement for this caboose area up here out of steel angle iron to support with the rods coming down to support the weight of somebody coming and sleeping up there. Plus all the flooring and everything underneath here is all new. New carpeting, new paneling inside and stuff. Put an air conditioner in. Gotta have air conditioning. I cannot stand camping when I'm miserable. So anyway, this is an axle out of a mobile home that I shortened and sectioned so that it would fit this trailer. And then I used turnbuckles. You can see the turnbuckles there to attach it to the trailer frame. And I towed it up here with my FedEx truck, believe it or not. Parked it in here with an ATV. Went with the German military camouflage so that it would blend into the woods and wouldn't be an eyesore to people. That's the back of it right there. I gotta get up on the roof today and shovel that snow off. That's too much snow for the roof. But anyway, oh, here's my Wheeler ATV. I traded my Mudder Jeep for this. I'm very glad I did because I used the living daylights out of this thing up here. This is my shed that I put up. Again, I painted it German camouflage to blend in with the woods so it wouldn't draw attention. But it's 12 by 14, just a tin shed. And I put a wooden floor in it. And it's my workshop. So I got a little workshop up here. I wired it for electricity. I store the snowblower in here. I got another ATV in here, a three-wheeler. The lawnmower's in here. Tools, gas cans. Got a microwave oven in here. If I want to make something real quick, I just come out here and make it. My little workbench up there where I can wrench on stuff, and I've had to use that quite a bit. I'll use it today, as a matter of fact, because I have to put snow chains on the ATV. Can't get any traction, so I got to put the snow chains on. So I'll be working out here today. But the ATV fits in here. It's a tight fit, but she fits in here. So this is where the four-wheeler stays. Got the minnows. I'm going to do some ice fishing later. I'll bring you guys along. Anyway, that's my work shed. Alright, let's go around the back side of the camper here. Well, anyway, this is the power box that I put in to get electricity up to the camper. Over that precipice there is that steep hill that I showed you in one of the videos before when I was making those trails. Down at the bottom of that hill is the meter base. The utility company, there's a power pole across the road. They trenched underneath the road, brought power over to the base of my hill here. I put in a meter base and then ran my own wiring up here, 200 amp service to service the camper. Got a yard light, of course. Got to have bright light around here so the bears don't surprise you. This is a plug-in. One is for the camper, and one is for a hot water heater for showers that I'll show you here. Outside outlet. We're all set. Come around this side of the camper. You see what I did was I took the wire or the cable for the camper and I unplug it every time I leave. It's not wired in, so it's portable. This whole camper is portable. And then it just wraps around those brackets right there. Just coils up, stored out of the way. This is the drain for the kitchen sink, which goes into this bucket here. And at the end of the week, or the end of the time we're up here, we just empty it into the woods. So, a couple of yard lights on the side there to light it up. That's the antenna for the radio. Being in the middle of East Jesus Nowhere, there's the tree that I put the antenna on for the TV. Being in the middle of nowhere, I don't get much reception for anything. That's the utility room. This is where I put another sub panel in. So I'm triply protected for electricity. And that's the propane for the cook stove. And some more electricity in there. Mouse trap, of course. That's the utility room. Alright, let's go inside. Now, you gotta remember, this camper was nothing but a piece of junk when I got it. And, spent a year working on it. So this is coming in the door here. Spent a year to remodel it. All new carpet. Floor was okay, so I just put carpet on the floor. Camper was from the 60s and the 70s, so you can see the color of the sink and the color of the stove. That's what this whole place looked like. But anyway, the range hood didn't work, so I got that working now. So I can sit in here and smoke a pipe and not get totally smoked out. My wife made the curtains, and she made the covers for the sofa. There was no cushions for the sofa, so she made the covers for the sofa. She made the covers for the pillows, and she also made this headrail, this rub rail right here, and she's got little bees on there to match the little bees that are in the curtains. Okay, that's that new bunk. All new knotty pine. Let me get up there and turn the light on once. Maybe you can see that now a little better. All new knotty pine paneling. All new ceiling. Again, she made the curtains. We put a couple of mattresses in here from a sleeper sofa, and then I put carpeting on the bunk there to make it a little nicer there. We painted the walls. There's a nice little saying. I don't know if you can read that. Is there anybody out there that can relate? All the walls were just terrible, so we painted the walls. Then I put up some splash wall material on the back side of there, of the stove. It needs a little bit of a cleaning. We haven't cleaned it in a while. We painted all the doors on all the cabinets. Cabinet doors open up like that, so you got storage for food. More food. Because you know me, I like to eat. Dishes. It was pretty nice to have that. Now the big thing, one of the big things is a water supply. I have actually running water in here. It's only cold though. But this is my utility room in here. And I don't think you can see, the light's not very good, but there's a water pump I installed in there. And that water pump goes to... we use water jugs, 7-gallon water jugs, that I fill up at the neighbor's. Gotta sit you down a minute. I fill the water jugs up at the neighbor's house down the road, and for free. And then the water jugs go in here, and then this hose right here, that hose goes down into the water jug. And then you turn on the water here at the sink, and the pump kicks on, and you have running water at the sink. You also have running water at the shower.